Hi, I'm Jackie Britton, and it's time for another Football Friday's Flashback. This one comes on October 9th. It was the McEachern Indians taking on the North Cobb Warriors, and McEachern really had control of this game from the very beginning. It was our first look at defensive tackle Julian Rochester for the Indians, and in my opinion, this was the best player that we saw on Football Fridays in Georgia. This was a tall task, though, for the Warriors, and it was a tough ball game for them. Here are some of the highlights.
Jump ball, and it is caught for a touchdown by Roberson. Roberson with his first touchdown catch of the season and showing off his athleticism for the Mississippi State Bulldog fans, wins the jump ball. It's 27-0. Dominguez remains perfect on his PATs this season. Your TCSG touchdown replay and the first touchdown pass of the night for Hockman. Might have been a little push off
just
by
a little nudge. Just
Robertson, Roberson as well. That's a tough job for Gilbert Blow right there. Gilbert Blow, the corner, he's 5'10".
It's a tough job for anybody, though. Yeah. A guy that tall, that's a tough assignment. At the next level, that's a tough assignment when you have a target that tall.
Simmons has it. Clear lane to the end zone, and he will score standing up. 21-yard touchdown pass from Hockman to Simmons. And it is 34-0. Second touchdown pass of the night for Hockman. First touchdown catch of the night for Simmons, who also had a touchdown run erased. I was right earlier. They had three touchdowns erased by penalties. Yeah, I was right the first time. It should be
excellent execution here.
This would make it 61-0.
Gives the ball out to Simmons, and there's nothing in front of him but green grass. All the way in for the score.
There you go. McEachern took it home 35-0. Now for the Warriors, they have a young team led by a young quarterback. They finished this year 5-6 under head coach Shane Queen. The Indians were led by quarterback Bailey Hockman and his father, head coach Kyle Hockman. They finished the season 10-2 before losing in the second round of the playoffs. Don't forget that you can stay up to date with us even in the off season here on GPB Sports. You can find us at Facebook and on Twitter at GPB Sports for all of your high school football news and notes in the off season. That'll do it for now, and we'll see you next time.